मत चिल्लाओ नहीं, प्लीज बाय। हेलो एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून श्री त्रिशा, अक्षया, श्री विद्या, वेलकम टू द क्लास। हाय एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग द रैपिड रिवीजन सीरीज फॉर अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर रिगार्डिंग द नीट एग्जामिनेशन। वेटेज वाइज दिस चैप्टर इज आल्सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। सम ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस, 30 क्वेश्चंस वी आर डिस्कसिंग टुडे हियर, एंड द चैप्टर व्हिच टुडे वी आर कवरिंग इज द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। सो आई एम अज्यूमिंग यू हैव अ गुड रिवीजन एट होम थ्योरी वाइज एंड यू हैड अ लॉट ऑफ प्रैक्टिस। सो here I am starting with the first question of this session. I hope I am audible to all of you. Shri Vidya, Akshya and Shri Trisha, good afternoon guys. Good afternoon to everyone. So here is the first question. The endosperm is completely consumed by the developing embryo in all of the following except. The endosperm is completely consumed. There are two cases. The fate of the endosperm. Either the endosperm is completely consumed, or in some cases, there are few cases only where the endosperm is not consumed. Okay, the endosperm is consumed because it is providing the nutrient to the developing embryo, and the embryo is formed after the division in the zygote. So there are two fate of the endosperm, which is a triploid body, and either it is completely consumed to provide the nourishment to the developing embryo, or it is not consumed totally. Okay, so hi Harsha. So what should be the answer? Groundnut and beans and castor. But there are few cases where the endosperm is not completely consumed. So what is the option here which should be corrected? Except, read the statement correctly. I always said as, read the statement correctly. Pea, groundnut, beans and castor. So here in this question, two type of varieties are given in which the endosperm is completely consumed, and another one is where the endosperm is not consumed. Okay, so I am waiting for the response from others also. Please give your input. Akshya, what about the others? Yes, Neha, welcome to the class. So it is, the answer is D, yes. Because endosperm may either be completely consumed. As I said, there are two varieties. Either the endosperm, which is a triploid body, it is already consumed to provide the nourishment to the developing embryo. Or there are some seeds before they, it may persist in the mature seed, like in castor and coconut. So along with castor, you have to learn coconut also, and be used during seed germination. So all of you have given the right answer. Pea, groundnut and beans are the one in which endosperm is completely consumed. But in some mature seed, it is persist. And the example of one is the castor, another one is the coconut. Okay, I am moving to the second question. What indicates A in the following figure? Very good, Akshya. What indicates A in the following figure? I am asking, what is the figure? This diagram is of which stage in a plant life, This diagram is of, it is of embryo, it is of seed, it is of fruit. What is this? It is embryo sac. Please write down. Please write down the answer for question number 2. It is a micropyle, it is an endosperm, it is cotyledon, it is scutellum. Scutellum, the single cotyledon present in the monocots in some grasses like cotyledons, the two cotyledons are present, dicots and monocots. It is 1 in case of monocots, it is 2 in case of dicots. Micropylar end is there in the embryo sac, and endosperm is the triploid bodies which provide the nourishment the developing embryo. So what should be the A? And this is the diagram exactly from the NCRT. Again and again in every session I am saying very, very important to go through the diagrams of NCRT as well as the ray diagrams, flow diagrams, and each and every line of NCRT is very, very important. So what should be the answer? What is A? How it is cotyledon, Shri Trisha? How it is cotyledon? Cotyledon, if you see, in case of that it is present, it is given like this. Okay, suspensor and here. Suspensor cells are here, then the two cotyledons are in case of dicot. In case of monocot, the structure is like this. Here it is epiblast and one cotyledon is present. Okay, in case of monocots. So this is not the cotyledon, it cannot be cotyledon. Dhanuja. It is not the endosperm. This diagram is only taken from NCRT and this question has been asked several times. So very, very important to go through all the diagrams of NCRT. It is the micropyle. The micropyle is present in the form of a pore in case of a seed. And this micropyle is helpful in providing the oxygen and water to the seed, to the growing seed. So it is the micropyle. It is not scutellum, it is not cotyledon, it is not endosperm. Okay guys, Neha, it is not scutellum because scutellum is a single cotyledon present in the some of the monocots like the grasses. And this is also very important. So always go through all the diagrams. Yes, Shri Trisha, go through the diagrams of the NCRT. Very, very, very important. On page number 29 or 30 or I think around 32. There is a list of diagrams, 7 to 8 diagrams on given on the same page for various type of seeds which are very important. And also other diagrams of NCRT of each and every chapter. Give your 2 days or 1 days for revision of all the diagrams. Okay. The embryo of a grass seed is enclosed by 2 protective sheaths. The embryo of a grass seed is enclosed by 2 protective sheaths. Okay, read the statement carefully. First, which covers the young shoot. Second, which covers the young root. Grass seed, it means they are talking about the monocots. Okay guys, first of all, go through the statement. Learn one by one what they are asking. So you have to tell them about the structure of monocots. So if you have gone through the structure of monocots, then you will be able to give the example. And this is the, again, this question has been asked several times in various form. You may not find the same lines, but you may find the question having the same type of statement. So what should be the answer? Which covers the young shoot and which covers the young root? If you gone through the recorded modules or the previous session which I have taken, there I have explained very well that polyptyle, if it is R, then it is for roots. To remember, it is a trick. Okay, both starting with the C, and it is P, then it is for the shoot. Okay, so answer you have given very right. It is polyptyle and coleorhiza. ओके गाइस, इज इट क्लियर? एम्ब्रियोज ऑफ मोनोकॉटिलीडॉन्स पजेस ओनली वन कॉटिलीडॉन. इन द ग्रास फैमिली द कॉटिलीडॉन इज कॉल्ड स्कूटेलम एंड दिस इज अगेन वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेंबर. That is situated towards the one side of the embryonal axis. At its lower end, the embryonal axis has the radicle, the root cap enclosed in an undifferentiated seed called coleorrhiza. Okay, the portion of the embryonal axis above the level of attachment of scutellum is apicotyle. The apicotyle has a shoot apex and a leaf primordia enclosed in a hollow foliar structure coleoptile that is giving rise to shoot. And so this is the structure of a monocot seed. Okay, so this is the scutellum, a single cotyledon in case of the grass family, monocots, coleoptile covering the shoot apex. Epiplast is the remnant of the second cotyledon. It is not developed in case of monocots. Okay, and when it is fully developed, then this is the case in case of the dicots. So here it is the radical, root cap, and this is the coleorrhiza above the radical. So answer is the coleoptile and coleorrhiza. So answer is C here. Okay guys, question number 4. Going to the question number 4, perisperm is degenerate secondary nucleus. It is remnant of nucellus, peripheral part of endosperm, or it is degenerative synergy. So what should be the answer? Please give your responses for question number 4. For question number 4, give your responses. That's other two answer. Perisperm is Anuja, Akshya, Neha and Shri Vidya. This answer is very very easy for all of you. You have given right answer. Perisperm is actually the remnant of nucellus. Okay, so answer for this is B. As it is clear, so we are not giving too much of time to this question. But I am giving you an explanation of albuminous seeds are there and exalbuminous seeds are there. Albuminous seeds which retain a part of endosperm, as it is not completely used up during embryo development. So examples here are wheat, maize, barley and castor. But occasionally in some seeds, you have to remember the name of black pepper and beet. Again and again in every session, I am giving emphasis on reading NCERT line by line. And again with the whole content. Third, the examples. Learn as much as example you can learn, which all are given in NCERT. Every line, every example, every diagram is very important to learn. So in some seeds like black pepper and beet, remnants of nucellus are also persistent. This residual is called perisperm. Okay. Okay, Shri Trisha. So going for the question number 5. Identify A and B in this figure. Identify A and B in this diagram. It is a ovary with syncarpous ovary. It is a filament with ovary. It is a stigma with filament, or it is a syncarpous ovary with stigma. So if you see the diagram, this is the diagram of a female reproductive part. Okay. So this is the diagram of a female reproductive part. So who is going to write the answer first? Normally it is like this. And this is the stigma for or the receptacle for adherence of the pollens. This is the female reproductive part. Style ovary. In some cases, there are one carpel. In some cases, there are more than one carpel. So, there are two types of conditions. One is the syncarpus condition. Second one is the apocarpus condition. Okay. Hi, Jivita. You can go with the four questions which I have taken after the class. You can continue for the question number 5. So, I am waiting for the answer. So, there is one condition when the carpels are not fused together. And there is another condition. Who is going to write the example of the syncarpus ovary? Where it is found? Yes, when the carpels are fused together, they form a syncarpus ovary. So, here it is the syncarpus ovary and it is the stigma. The answer is right, which is given by each of you. Very nice. So, go through the diagram. There are 3 or 4 diagrams given continuously on the NCRT for syncarpus and apocarpus type of condition. And below the diagrams, always there is written content which you have to learn properly. Multicarpillary syncarpus pistil of Papaver. Which of the following is false? Question number 6. Which of the following is false? Question number 6. Endosperm formation starts prior to the first division of zygote. One of the male sperm fuses with the central polar nuclei. One of the sperm fuses with the egg cell. And which one fuses with the egg cell? It forms the zygote. Here are the antipodal cells. At the chalazal ends. And these are the synergids, which form a filiform apparatus during the entry of the pollen tube, and they facilitate the entry of the pollen tube. Okay, so what should be the answer here? They are asking about the endosperm. So, endosperm formation starts prior to first division of zygote. They are saying false. Did it correctly. The endosperm is mostly 3N. Polar nuclei is 2N. Then again one sperm is coming, then it is 3N. The most common type of endosperm is nuclear type. When there is no cytokinesis and there is free division. And there are many nuclei present without the formation of cell wall. Then it is a free nuclear type of endosperm. Okay. Coconut has both liquid, nuclear and cellular endosperm. During the development of the endosperm, first of all, there is free nuclear type of endosperm. Second thing, after the formation of free nuclei, which is a multinucleate condition, there is the cytokinesis in that. And when the formation of cell wall takes place, then it changes into cellular endosperm. So, in case of a coconut, the liquid which is present inside, that is a nuclear, free nuclear type of endosperm, by the kernel of the coconut, that is the cellular endosperm. Okay. Milky water of green tender coconut is liquid female gametophyte. So, what is a false option in this? I have given explanation for all the four. And endosperm formation always start prior to the division in the zygote, because endosperm is ensuring to provide the nourishment to the developing embryo. So, what should be the answer here? 1 and 2 only are false, 3rd is false, 5th is false, or 2nd is false. What should be the answer for question number 6? तनुजा नेहा एंड बिसाइड ऑफ बोथ श्रीविता श्री त्रिषा श्री विद्या अक्षया. यस इट इज सी. इट इज सी बिकॉज आई हैव एज आई सेड इट इज द लिक्विड न्यूक्लिएट एंडोस्पर्म एंड द सेलुलर एंडोस्पर्म. ओके सो आई होप दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर विद यू. इफ यू हैव एनी कंफ्यूजन इन थ्योरी ऑल ऑफ यू देर आर फाइव सेशन प्रेजेंट ऑन द सेम चैनल सेम पोर्टल ऑफ सेलुलर रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स. देर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक इन डिटेल सो यू कैन गो थ्रू द थ्योरी पार्ट. दीज आर लाइक इन 5 hours यू कैन कवर द होल चैप्टर. ओके द और यू कैन यू डोंट नीड टू गो फॉर द होल थिंग. यू कैन सी द टॉपिक्स इन विच यू आर लैकिंग और यू आर हैविंग सम कंफ्यूजन. ओके गाइज क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. डायग्राम गिवन बिलो शोज स्टेजेस इन एम्ब्रियोजेनेसिस इन ए टिपिकल डायगॉट कैप्सुला. कैप्सुला इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ए टिपिकल एंजियोस्पर्मिक प्लांट. आइडेंटिफाई स्ट्रक्चर ए टू डी. आइडेंटिफाई द स्ट्रक्चर्स ए टू डी. वॉट शुड बी द आंसर फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर द रेस्पॉन्स. Here it is the zygote. These are the stages in the development of the embryo. Okay. So the division takes place inside the zygote. As you can see, transverse division. Then there is the formation of a globular embryo. And here is the neck-like structure. And this is the suspensor cell. So after that, there is the heart-shaped embryo. Because it is like there is the formation of this heart shape. So these are what? These are the suspensor cells. These are 6 to 10 cells present. Now there is the radical. These are the two cotyledons. And before the cotyledons, this is the plumule. I think this is diagram is clear with you. So the answer here is given by all of you is very very correct. It is A. Okay guys, and again I am saying go through all the diagrams. Which are the external conditions required for seed germination? During the process of seed germination, ovules, zygote changes into embryo. Okay, and primary endosperm nucleus changes into endosperm. Seed changes, ovules changes into seed and ovary changes into fruit. So, for seed germination, what are the conditions which are required, external conditions? Question number 8. Srividya, is that there is no need of oxygen? Cannot go for light as light is a important part for photosynthesis. Without the photosynthesis, the plant cannot survive. So, external conditions. Why it is C? Everyone is giving the answer C. Yes, Tanuja, oxygen is required. And the embryo may enter a state of inactivity that is called dormancy. And if favorable conditions are available, what are the favorable conditions for seed germination if these favorable conditions are not present? Like adequate moisture, oxygen and the suitable temperature. If this is not available to them, then there is a state of inactivity of the seed. It will not germinate and this is called the dormancy. So the option D D is correct, and you know all these lines are from NCERT, and all these questions are asked several times in different forms. May not be you will find the same language, you may find different choices in different type of questions. Okay, so each and every line of NCERT is very, very, very important. So the answer here it is D. Question number 9, which one of the following may require pollinators but is genetically similar to autogamy? Auto means self. Xenogamy, xenogamy, apogamy, cleistogamy. Cleistogamy, the state where the flowers are closed. Reproductive flower parts are not exposed. Apogamy, xenogamy, zitanogamy. What should be the answer for question number 9? Can you give me the reason for this? Can you give me the reason for this? Yes, the answer is A here. What should be the reason for this? Autogamy, on the same flower, both the male and female parts are reproductive parts are present. So there is no need of pollinators because they can come close to each other. Xenogamy, what should be the reason? I am asking for the reason. Because pollination is categorized broadly into two categories, that is self-pollination and cross-pollination. In self-pollination, there are two categories which are placed. One is the autogamy, second one is the zitanogamy. Because the male and female parts are present on the same plant. Autogamy, they are present on the same flower. Zitanogamy, they may be present on the different flowers. So they may require pollinators, but genetically they are similar. This is the reason. As you can see in this pollination, there is self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination, autogamy, zitanogamy, and based on plant, it is allogamy, anemophily, hydrophily, zoophily. Okay. Yes, yes. Srividya, very nice. Question number 10. Flowers which have single ovule in the ovary and are packed into inflorescence are usually pollinated by. Srividya, they do not need pollinating agents. They need pollinating agents, yes, yes, yes. But genetically they are same. Which have single ovule in the ovary and are packed into inflorescence are usually pollinated by water, bee, wind or bat. What should be the answer here? Question number 10, I am waiting for others to answer. Yes, it is wind pollination or anemophily. Okay. Wind pollinated flowers often have a single ovule in each ovary and numerous flowers packed into an inflorescence. A familiar example is of corn cob. Maize. The tassels you see are nothing but the stigma and style which wave in the wind to trap pollen grains. And wind pollination is very common in case of grasses. Because for wind pollination, the pollen should be of lighter. They should be light. But there is no need of colorful flowers or colorful things. ओके ए डायोसियस फ्लावरिंग प्लांट प्रिवेंट्स बोथ, ए डायोसियस फ्लावरिंग प्लांट प्रिवेंट्स। क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, वी आर रनिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम, सो बी क्विक इन आंसरिंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 11। ऑटोगैमी एंड जीनोगैमी, ऑटोगैमी एंड जिटेनोगैमी, जिटेनोगैमी एंड जीनोगैमी, क्लिस्टोगैमी एंड जीनोगैमी। मोनोसियस प्लांट हैविंग द बोथ मेल एंड फीमेल यूनिट ऑन द सेम प्लांट सेम फ्लावर, एंड इफ इट इज डायोसियस प्लांट देन व्हाट इट शुड प्रिवेंट, इट शुड प्रिवेंट सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन। यस द आंसर इज बी हियर, वेरी नाइस। As this answer is given by all of you, so we don't need so much of time here. Question number 12. Which one of the following statement is not true? Exine of pollen grains is made up of sporopollenin. Pollen grains of many species causes severe allergies. We have seen this. And exine is made up of sporopollenin. Stored pollen in liquid nitrogen can be used in crop breeding programs. Tapetum help in the dehiscence of anther. If we see the structure of anther, there are four type of cells, layers, covering. Endothecium, epidermis, endothecium, tapetum, middle layer on tapetum. And this is the endothecium which help in the dehiscence of the anther. So not true, what is not true? Yes, it is D. Tapetum is providing the nourishment. Their role is providing the various type of amino acids and minerals, and it is not involved in the dehiscence of anther. It is the endothecium there which is involved in the dehiscence of the anther. And exine is made up of sporopollenin. Question number 13. Question number 13. Question number 13. This is the diagram. Strawberry. And they are asking about A and B. In most of the plant, the fruit, it develops from the ovary. And all the floral appendages, they degenerate. But there are some fruits, there are some plants in which the floral appendages are part of the fruit. They are part of the fruit. And this is the example of this only. In which the floral appendages, they take part in the formation of a fruit. And these type of fruits are known as false fruits. So, like in apple, like in strawberry, like in cashew, yes, it is the thalamus. A is the thalamus, B is the achene, and achene is a simple dry food which is present in many species of the flowering plants. So, answer here is B, which is given very correct by all of you. Very nice. Question number 14. Moving the question number 14. Read the statement very carefully always. Sometimes the answer is only in the statement which is provided. Choose the odd one with respect to gynecium. So they are talking about the female reproductive part of the flower. Gynecium represents the female reproductive part of flower. Yes, the gynecium may be syncarpous or apocarpous. The number of ovules in papaya and mango is 1. The ovules are attached to placenta. So guys, what should be the odd one out? It means the three are related with the gynecium, while the one option is not correct with respect to gynecium. The ovules are attached to placenta. Yes, it is right. It is also right. Syncarpus, apocondylus condition, just now in previous question we have seen. So the number of ovules is one in case of mango, but it is many in case of papaya. Okay, so answer here it is C. Yes, answer is right. Question number 15. Select the incorrect statement with respect to artificial hybridization. Incorrect statement with respect to artificial hybridization. Anther. Vasculation is the removal of anther in their mature condition from bisexual flower. Vasculation is not required in male sterile plants. Yes, if it is male sterile plant, then there is no need of emasculation. Emasculation is what? Emasculation is the removal of stamens from a bisexual flower of the female parents in order to avoid self-pollination. Why we are doing this? We are doing the artificial hybridization for the crop improvement, for the choice of the crop or the better nutritional quality of the crop we are needed, and we are going for the artificial hybridization. So we can artificially choose the male part. Okay, and unisexual female flower is bagged in bud condition to prevent contamination. Emasculated flowers are bagged in bud condition. During the emasculation, first of all, there is the removal of stamens. And it is before their dehiscence. Okay. Then there is another condition, that is bagging. There is another condition that is bagging. Okay. The butter papers are generally used to bag the flowers. So what should be the answer here? Why it is D? See, this type of questions need to be attempted very carefully. Guys, why? Because I am giving you why I have written here. I want to give you an example how to attempt these type of questions which have little. Like, if here it is given bagged in bud condition just before the flowering, then it will not be the incorrect statement. It will be the correct statement. Your answer is right. Just we are discussing this question. I want to discuss this type of questions because you have to carefully attempt. Because if you go, you may find this answer as the right answer somewhere. But this is not the right answer. This is the right answer. Okay, emasculated flowers are bagged in. Why there is no need of bagging? Okay, so these type of questions need to be attempted very carefully. Emasculation involves the removal of stamens. Have to be covered with a bag of suitable size, generally made up of butter paper, to prevent contamination of its stigma with unwanted pollen. That's why we are doing it. The female parent produces unisexual flower. There is no need of emasculation. The female flower buds are bagged, but before the flowers open, not generally. So this is the answer for this question. Okay, and sometimes if it is not given, but this another option is given which is correct, you may go for this. You may go for if this is not given. Okay. So, always attempt the question very, very carefully. See the choices, the kind of choices which is provided, and most appropriate choices should not be eliminated. Question number 16. क्वेश्चन नंबर 16, एग्जामिन द फिगर गिवन बिलो एंड सेलेक्ट द राइट ऑप्शन गिविंग ऑल द फोर पार्ट्स ए बी सी डी करेक्टली आइडेंटिफाई ए बी सी डी. This is the diagram for the seed and for the structure of a apple. What should be the answer for question number 16? Thalamus, seed, endocarp, mesocarp. Thalamus, seed, mesocarp, endocarp. Mesocarp, seed, endocarp, thalamus. We know that A, if you see the structure, always try to eliminate the wrong choices first of all. It is the thalamus. As I have given you in the previous question also, apple, strawberry, cashews are some false fruits are there in which thalamus is the part of the fruit. Okay, so A is thalamus here, so you can eliminate these if you don't know the answer, how to attempt these type of questions. But you are sure that it is thalamus. So you can eliminate these two choices as such. Now B, these are the seeds as you can see. But in both of the choices, seed is given. C is the endocarp and D is the mesocarp. So answer 16 is A, which is given correctly by all of you. Anemophily type of pollination is found in salvia, bottle brush, valisneria and coconut. What should be the answer for question number 17? Pollination is very very important topic to learn each and every example from this. We don't know from where the question is coming. Might be it come from the pollination. First, from every chapter 2 to 3 questions are coming. Yes, okay, so it may be from pollination, it may be from megasporogenesis or microsporogenesis, maybe post fertilization events or type of ovules. So you cannot left any topic unpolished, can say. Anemophily type of pollination is found in salvia, bottle brush, valisneria or coconut. Have a lot of practice at home, guys. Have a lot of practice and revision. Learn. Again, I am saying, learn the example, learn the diagrams to eliminate the confusion while attempting the multiple choice questions. If your theory is well prepared means 200% it is prepared, who will be able to attempt 100%. Why it is B? Pollination through air is known as anemophily, as I told you already. It is in example is coconut. Salvia, it is by insect. Entomophily. Valisneria, water. Hydrophily, a prominent diagram is given in NCERT for all these. Are very very important. The example of salvia, the example of valisneria, bottle brush, it is by birds. Ornithophily, very very important to learn by the help of diagrams. So today only for revision of the subtopic pollination from NCERT, every line. Sometime they will ask you the type of pollen grains, why they facilitate anemophily, what type of in the entomophily the pollen grains are, the flowers are colored, nectar rich so that they attract the insects. So this is a very, very important topic to be covered. Okay, guys? Question number 18. Question number 18. If the nucellus cells of an angiosperm contains 24 chromosomes, the number of chromosomes present in pollen grain, endosperm and embryo will be. First you see it is N or 2N or 3N. Endosperm, as we know, it is 3N. Nucellus, what should be the answer for question number 18? Nucellus, it is 2N, 24 is given, pollen grain is N, it is 12, endosperm is 3N, it is 36, embryo is again 2N, zygote, that is 24. Yes, Shri Vidya, Shri Trisha, Neha, your answer is right, it is 12, 36, 24. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear? Yes, yes, it is B. Ruminate endosperm is commonly found in seeds of which family? Ruminate endosperm is the condition in which the endosperm it is dissected by ingrowth of the seed coat. So this type of structure is there. And it is present in which? Forbiaceae, Cruciferi, Palmaceae or Ariaceae, Compositae. It is a feature of one of the plant family. Waiting for the answer. 19. Question number 19. The answer for this is C. Ruminate endosperm is the condition in which the endosperm is dissected by ingrowth of the seed coat, and it is common condition in the palms family. And the condition is like this. Okay. Question number 20. Question number 20. Examine the figure given below and select the right option giving all the four parts A, B, C, D. What here it is given? It is given the structure of the anther. Yeah, four lobed anther. Sorry. And make. And this is the sectional view of this one. Microsporangia. Okay, and here this is the structure they are giving. Correctly identify A, B, D, C. Who? What should be the answer for question number 20? Question number 20, it is endothecium, tapetum, endothecium, tapetum, endothecium, middle layer, and microspore mother cell, middle layers. What should be the answer? A is, like last one is the epidermis. Epidermis is followed by endothecium. So you can eliminate this tapetum. Now, after the endothecium, they are asking about the B. What about the others for question number 20? Endothecium. What is D? D is microspore mother cell. C is tapetum. B is middle layer. So answer is C here. Answer is C here. Yes, right. Question number 21. The type of cells undergoing meiosis in the flowers are microspore mother cell. This is MMC. This is also MMC. Microspore mother cell means we are talking about the microsporogenesis. Megaspore mother cell, megasporogenesis. Ovule and stamen, tapetal cells and placental cells. So this is not, this is not. Out of these, what should be the answer? Meiosis in the flowers. One meiotic division in microspore mother cells takes place and one in the megaspore mother cells. Tetrad formation from their four pollen grains, four microsporangium are formed. In megaspore, four were formed but only one remained, three degenerate after the meiosis. So what should be the answer for 21? I have given the answer here only. What about the others? The type of cells undergoing meiosis in the flowers, what are these? These are none other than microspore mother cell and megaspore mother cell. Okay. So your answer is right, everyone. Moving to the question number 22. Moving to the question number 22. In which of the following fruit is the edible part of the aril? It is custard apple, pomegranate, orange or lychee. Question number 22. For question number 22, what about the others? It is lychee or custard apple or pomegranate or orange. Edible part of the aril. Is A. The answer given by Neha is very correct. Aril is the edible part of lychee. It is the fleshy part which covers the seed. It is a specialized outgrowth from a seed that partially or completely covers the seed. And aril creates a false fruit like appearance. So answer for the question number 22, it is A. Okay guys, all of you. For all of you, the answer for question number 22, aril is the edible part of the lychee. Okay, is it clear? I am moving to the question number 23. What is incorrect? Which statement is incorrect? Intine is the inner wall of pollen grain and exhibit fascinating array of pattern and designs. The mature pollen grain has two cells. The bigger one is the vegetative cell. The smaller is the generative cell. This like. This is the generative. This is the vegetative cells. Carrot grass pollens cause no pollen energy. Yes. Pollen grains of pea and rose maintain viability for months. Means the survival period for the pollen grains is for months. It is not just for 1 or 2 days or 1 or few hours. So what should be the answer? which is one is the incorrect one for question number 23. Which statement is incorrect? Read the statement carefully, guys. It is about the intine. It is about the pollen grain cells after the division. There is formation of vegetative and generative cell, pollen grains allergy, and pollen grains viability in case of pea and rose. And all, you know, these questions, all the lines are from NCERT, and this type of questions may not be the same questions. These are asked several times in different questions. The statements you may find in different type of questions. What should be the answer? Incorrect answer. Read the statement carefully again, all of you. If you see the structure of the pollen grain, it has two layers. One is the exine, inner one is the intine. Yes? And this is the exine in which the sporopollenin is present, which is the most resistant material till now. And between them, there are the germ pores. Apertures are there from which the pollen tubes arises. So, intine is one which is a complete layer. It does not exhibit the array of pattern and designs in it. But the pollen grains of pea and rose, they maintain viability for months. So Neha, your answer is very much correct. And Shri Trisha, Shri Vidya, I hope why the answer is A. This is, the question is asking which is incorrect. It is not asking about which is correct. Okay guys, Shri Trisha, Vidya, Jivita, and Akshya, Dhanuja, the reason is clear now why the answer is A for question number 23. Is it clear? The fascinating array of pattern and design it exhibit in case of exine. Intine is internal to the exine. Yes, 23A. The answer for question number 23, it is A. Question number 24. Which of the following options is correct? Which of the following options is correct? Pollination gives the guarantee of the promotion of post-pollination event that leads to fertilization. The events from pollen deposition on stigma until pollen tube enter the ovule are together referred to as pollen piston interaction. Third one, pollen piston interaction is a dynamic process involving pollen recognition followed by only promotion of the pollen. Piston has no ability to recognize the pollen whether right or wrong type. Read the statement correctly. All the four statements are given for the pollen piston interaction. Interaction. So in case of pollen piston interaction, the piston has the ability to recognize whether the right type of pollen is coming or not coming. Okay, but it does not ensure the pollination process does not ensure that there will be fertilization. If there is fusion of male and female gamete, then only there is fertilization. The pollen is going to be transferred, but may or may not be, it is recognized by the piston. So what should be the answer for question number 24? And synergids plays an important part in recognition pollen piston interaction. And because the synergids secrete some chemicals which facilitate or which help in recognizing right type of pollen grain. So the answer here it is B. Very nice, Shri Vidya, Shri Trisha, Neha. The answer is B for question number 24. Okay. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर विद यू व्हाई इट इज द इवेंट फ्रॉम पोलन डिपोजिशन ऑन द स्टिग्मा अंटिल पोलन ट्यूब एंटर्स द ओव्यूल आर टूगेदर रिफर टू एज द पोलन पिस्टल इंटरेक्शन. सो दिस इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Pita, it should not be A. They are asking about the correct option. But once the pollination is done, the transfer of the pollen grains to the stigma, that is only pollination. But it does not guarantee the promotion of the post-pollination events. And what is the post-pollination event? The pollen after the adherence of the pollens to the stigma may or may not be necessary. It facilitates or it leads to the process of fertilization. Because there is an important event which is known as pollen pistil interaction, which has to be done, then only it ensures when the both of the male gametes go inside and they fuses with the one of the polar nuclei and one with the egg cell. Question number 25. Female flowers remain submerged in water and the pollen grains are released inside the water in it is seagrass, vallisneria, water lily and water hyacinth. Again I am saying pollination is very very important and each and every line, every word which is given on two pages of NCERT, here only you will find the answer of all the MCQs which you may find in any kind of book. So revision of NCERT is very 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 important. What should be the answer for question number 25? What should be the what should be the answer for question number 25? Female flowers, they remain submerged in water and the pollen grains are released inside the water. It is a case in case of sea grasses. Your answer is right, Shri Trisha. It is a case in case of sea grasses. Water pollinated plants such as sea grasses, female flowers remain submerged in water and the pollen grains are released inside the water. And pollen grains in many such species, they are very long, ribbon-like and they are carried passively inside the water and some of them reach the stigma and achieve pollination. And one important feature is that they have a mucilage covering over them, protect them from wetting. So answer, it is sea grasses. Okay, so everyone have a revision of pollination subtopic very well, because probability of coming the question 70% from this chapter is from pollination. I'm not saying it will come from this only. I'm saying the probability of coming the questions, or generally they are coming from pollination. One question generally it comes from pollination and it is about the type and examples, not about the chart which we were reading. It's about the examples which are given. Only the 4 and 5 detailed explanation of pollination mechanism is given in NCERT, which is very important to learn. 26. Which one of the following represents an ovule where an embryo sac becomes horseshoe shaped? When I am saying horseshoe shape, automatically the answer should be in your mind. And the funiculus and micropyle are close to each other. So they are talking about the type of ovule. There are many type of ovules depending upon the its shape. Some are straight, some are totally inverted, like this. Some are having horseshoe shaped. Some are totally 360 degree inverted. Some are straight. So what should be the answer for question number 26, in which the embryo sac become the horseshoe shaped? It is a prominent feature of this type of ovule. What should be the answer for question number 26? If you have difficulty in attempting the questions, you may go to the sessions which were taken by me few days back. There are 5 sessions and the links are present on here only, and you may find on the portal also, and have a revision of the topics in which you are feeling difficulty. Okay. It is Circinotropus, Anatropus, Amphitropus or Atropus? Yes, it is Amphitropus. Shita, Shri Trisha, Neha, what about the others? Here you can see it is the diagram of a Amphitropus type of ovule. And the funicles and micropyle, they are close to each other. Like this is the micropylar end. Yes, and this is the funicle. This is the chalazal end. This is the shape. The embryo sac is taking the shape of a horseshoe. So that's why it is known as the horseshoe shaped type of ovule. Answer is 26. Question number 27. Question number 27. Parthenogenesis occurs. It should be very easy question for all of you. Parthenogenesis occurs when the embryo is formed without the fusion of egg and sperm. When embryo is formed by the fusion of egg and sperm. When the embryo is formed from another cell, when sperm produces the embryo directly. What should be the answer for question number 27? Yes. What about the others? Divita and Akshya, Tanuja, Sri Trisha, Sri Vidya. I hope this session is very useful for all of you. Yes, it is a easy one. Direct question. When embryo is formed without the fusion of egg and sperm, then it is known as parthenogenesis. So answer for the question number 27, it is A. Question number 28, and I want everyone to give the right answer. How many meiotic divisions are required for the formation of 200 seeds of capsula? Capsula, there is no exception in this. This is an example of a, I am giving the clue also, example of a typical angiospermic plant. Okay guys, so what should be the number of meiotic division? What should be the number of meiotic division for formation of a seed? There should be fertilization. For fertilization, there should be male gamete and female gamete. If we go to the megasporogenesis, so you have to go back to the megasporogenesis and microsporogenesis. Neha, why it is 250? Microsporogenesis, after one meiotic division, there is the formation of 4 sperms. 4 after one meiotic division. Okay? And in megasporogenesis, 4 egg were formed, 3 degenerate, only 1 remaining. So for formation of 1 for 200 seed, they are asking, we are talking about a one seed here. And if you multiply the whole process for 200, that's other to answer. I am waiting for others to apply the logic and give the answer, because these type of questions generally come to calculate what should be 200, 400, 250 or 300. I have given the logic here. For one seed formation, one meiosis here, one here. For formation of one egg cell and one male sperm. Yes, the formula is X plus X by 4. X is for ovum formation, as from one meiosis, 4 are forming. For 4, 200, 200 divided by 4, it is 50. So it is 200 plus 200 by 4, that is 250. Okay. And the explanation is this. Okay, guys. Everyone, Shri Trisha, it is 250 only. Neha, it is 250. Is it clear? Jibita, Shri Vidya, Shri Trisha, and Akshya. Is it clear, guys? Is this numerical? Is clear why it is 250? Yes, I am moving to question number 29. When vegetative cells of sporophyte form an embryo, it is called apospory, apogamy, apomixis or adventive embryony. Polyembryony, formation of more than one embryo. And formation of embryo from the vegetative cells of sporophyte. Then it is called it is apospory, apogamy, apomixis and adventive embryony. Mohammad Jaseem, if you see X plus X by 4, because we are talking about the formation of a seed, and for the formation of a seed we need a ovum and a sperm fusion so that there is fertilization. Okay, so for a female part we are needing, like, for 200 seeds we need 200 ovum, and for during the megasporogenesis there is the formation of 4 cells here, and 3 degenerate and 1 is going to participate in fertilization process. Okay, but for the formation there are formation of 4 pollen grains, or the 4 sperms are formed from 1 meiosis. From 1 meiosis 4 are formed. For formation of 200 we need 200 by 4, so we need 50. Yes, I am explaining for you only. It is 50 number of sperms, number of meiotic division required for the formation, because from one meiosis we are getting 4 pollen grains. Are you getting me what I am saying? If you have gone through the process of megasporogenesis well and microsporogenesis, you are able to recall these things. You have to recall the process of megasporogenesis and microsporogenesis. So in megasporogenesis only the one egg is remained, 3 degenerate and they are going to support the development of this. So we need 200 meiotic division for formation of one. Here from one meiosis we are getting 4 sperm. So for 200, how many divisions, meiotic division we need? We need 200 by 4, so it is 50. It is 50. So for 200 seeds, 200 meiosis in फॉर एग फॉर्मेशन, 50 मियोसिस फॉर स्पर्म फॉर्मेशन. सो इट इज 250. ओके, इज इट क्लियर? आई होप इट इज क्लियर, बट यू हैव टू रिकॉल द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेगास्पोरोजेनेसिस एंड माइक्रोस्पोरोजेनेसिस. व्हेन वेजिटेटिव सेल्स ऑफ स्पोरोफाइट फॉर्म एन एम्ब्रियो, इट इज कॉल्ड एडवेंटिव एम्ब्रियोनी. एपोगैमी, गैमेटोफाइट, एपोस्पोरे, स्पोरोफाइट. Polyembryony is the occurrence of more than one embryo in a seed, whereas adventive polyembryony is the formation of embryo direct from the diploid sporophytic cell or the vegetative cell. Okay, so the answer for question number 29, it is 4. Question number 30th, last question of this session. I hope all the questions are very much clear with you. Have a revision of the topics in which you are having some difficulty in recalling the answer or the examples. Okay guys, so that's in this way this session is useful for you. Go back to the topics, give 2 minutes that we need revision for this. We have to learn this thing, we are lacking in these things. Okay, which one of the following pair of plant structures has haploid number of chromosome? If we see the structure, there are 3 antipodal cell, this is the egg cell, there are synergids, this is the polar nuclei. What should be the answer for question number 30th? This is egg cell. We are asking about N. Plant structure having the N number of chromosome. So it is the egg cell which is N. Antipodal cell, these are also N. Secondary nucleus, these are 2N. Megaspore mother cell, antipodal cell, 2N. So the nucleus, it is 2N. So answer is C. Answer is C. All of you are giving the right answer. So guys, if you like the session, like the link. Can like the link and you can do the favor by sharing the lessons or the links to your peer group or to your friends, so the other can also take a benefit from these sessions and go back to the revision if you have any difficulty in attempting these type of questions, and try to learn the examples as much as you can. This is for your benefit. If I am saying again, after 15 minutes go back to the theory, because preparing your theory, you have already given the examination. If once you know how important it is to learn the theory very well for biology, very very well, just for reading or superficial revision will not work. You are doing very well in these rapid revision series, but give your best, give your 200% so that you are able to do the 100% right choices in the examination. Always wait a second, read the statement carefully. Sometimes we do the silly mistakes. Prepare your theory very well. Okay, you can like the link and share with your friends. We will be meeting soon again with another wonderful session. Thank you so much guys. I am taking your leave. Bye bye, take care, do hard work.